Alright guys, today I'm going to be giving a shout out to the Ministry of Magic channel. They've been, you guys probably seen their comments down below. And also, quick thing, this is probably going to be my last upload just for a little bit because, you know, there's a hurricane coming through and I do live in Florida, so I'm probably going to be out of power for a while. And it's probably going to, you know, take me a second to get, you know, back into the swing of things, but I just want to let you guys know this is going to be my last video for a while because I don't know when I'm going to get internet after tonight. So anyways, make sure to check out the Ministry of Magic channel. They're really, really good, and I would highly advise you to stick around, watch the video here. The trick really did surprise me as well, so here is the video, guys.
Alright, so this is the Ministry of Magic, and it is my honor to do a collab with Hester23BearCH. He's probably one of the most famous magicians on YouTube, so thank you, Hester. And this is my favorite opener trick because it just grabs all the attention from the audience right away. So here's what the trick looks like. I'm gonna just get around half of the pack, it does not really matter, and I'll just use these cards. And right now, I'll give these cards a bit of a mix-up, so they're in random order. I'll place some on top, place some on bottom, place some on top, and place some on bottom. And the spectator could do this as well, he can shuffle the pack. But just to make it completely random, some cards go on top, some cards go on bottom. And I'll give the deck one more cut. Actually, I'll just keep cutting it until the spectator is satisfied. And if the spectator won, he can cut it himself, he can just mix these cards up a bit. And let's say spectator is satisfied right now. So I'll just give the deck one last cut to make sure everything is random. Now, I'll deal down 9 cards. So, just like that, 9 cards in any random order. And the spectator can either say no or yes as I go through these cards. So let's say spectator says no for first one. He said no again for the second one. He said yes for the third one. So I'll take the third card face up. He said yes again. He said no. He said no. He said yes. He said yes. And he said no. Okay, and these two cards, I'll just throw them out of here. And let's look at these cards. The 5 and a 4, no match. A 6 and a 5, no match. A 9 and a 6, no match. A 10 and a 9, no match. A 3 and a 10. Absolutely nothing between those cards, no connection absolutely whatsoever. But you could have said yes anytime. You shuffled the cards, you could have cut the cards. But look, the card you say yes to, the red 8 turns to the black 8. The black ace. The red ace. The black 2. I need a mat. A red 2. And finally, the red 7. The black 7. The spectator could have shuffled, spectator could have cut, said yes anytime, said no anytime, but they actually found perfect match 4 times. So that is the trick, and here is the tutorial for the trick. Here is the tutorial for the trick, so later I'll teach you guys how to shuffle the pack in a way to make this trick work, how to do the yes or no thing, and how to let the spectator shuffle the pack. So before I start, here's the setup. So this is gonna be your deck, and as I said, this is my favorite opener trick, so this is probably not gonna be a trick I end with or go in the middle because I usually have the setup on top. And so the setup is black, ace to 10, and the red ace to 10. You can do it in one suit, so you can say ace to 10 in all clubs and ace to 10 in all hearts. But because I just varied it a bit, so it makes it look more random. So spades, club, diamond, heart, diamond, heart. It doesn't really matter as long as you have ace to 10. And remember, if you put the, you have to make it in this specific order, or you can reverse both pile. So 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and this pile has to be in that order as well. So, but this is the pile I like to have it, and usually when I start the trick, I just put this on top, and I look through the pile just randomly, and I catch a break, and I just break it off, and my trick is good to go. So you're only gonna use the top 20 cards, your ace to 10 from both colors. So now, you'll give the deck a shuffle, but this is very important, because if you don't shuffle correctly, the whole trick is gonna be messed up. So this is how you do the shuffle. You're gonna bring some cards over here. You're gonna use your pinky to push off some cards from the bottom, put it on top. Use your thumb to push off some cards from the top, put it on bottom. Do it again, pinky some cards off the bottom, put it on top, do the same until you run out of cards. And then you can do it once again if the spectator looks suspicious. So take some cards, use your pinky, break off some card, put it on top, some cards on bottom, some cards on top, some cards on bottom, some cards on top, some cards on bottom. I'll go over this one more time just to make sure you understand it. Take some, the top card is, so first you're gonna break the top card. So this is just gonna be over here. Then use your pinky to push off some bottom card, put it on top, push off some top card, put it on bottom, push off some bottom card, put it on top of the pile, do the same until all the cards are done. So basically what you have right now is you're not gonna have 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, but you're gonna have this. You're gonna have the 8 to 10 in the middle, and the red ace is gonna be like 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 10. So that's okay. And you can give the deck a few cuts. Remember, the spectator should not riffle shuffle, so you can just ask the spectator to cut the cards anywhere. You can do a Charlie or you can do a Revolution, it does not really matter. And now the deck is not mixed up more, it's just still this, but this time it's ace, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is on this side. So the size doesn't matter, it's just make sure you have the order correct. So now, since it doesn't matter, you're just gonna deal down 9 cards. And this part you could honestly let the spectator do, because some spectator, they question if you have some like advanced sleight of hand, Hogwarts thingamajigs. So now I'm gonna tell you guys how to do this part. So if the spectator say no, you're basically like, oh sir, just deal the top card down. If he says yes, this is what we're gonna do. You're gonna do a wrist kill, meaning turn your wrist. And as you're doing this, you're gonna use your thumb to push it down. So as you're doing it, push it down. You're not gonna take this card and put it up. Instead, when you push it down, you're gonna take this card. So I'll do it in the exposed view, okay? So take the second to top card, and make sure you slide this card down so you can take the second to top card up. So let's say spectator say no, just take the top card, put it face down. Spectator say yes, remember, use your thumb, push down the top card, do a wrist kill, then take the second from top, deal it down, say yes, let's say he say yes again, say no, say no. And the final two cards, they can just go anywhere, it does not really matter. And you're just gonna reveal first that the ones he said no to, there's absolutely no connection between them. And the ones he said yes to, he actually found the perfect soulmates, I mean, the same number to each and every one of them. So that is the trick. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, make sure you guys comment something down below. And thank you, Hester, for having me on your channel once again. She's a literal vampire, belly goblin, hobbling, now chasing after your mama. Ah, let's go.